Hello and welcome, ladies and gentlemen. I am Dark Grave Knight, and we are back with Dark Souls 3 DLC, Painted World of Ariamis. Wait, no. Paint the World of Ariandel. So that's a three-part boss fight. I basically finished everything but that. And now I cheated and I looked up what I'm supposed to do to get to the other boss. Shit, there is a ladder down there. How the fuck did you get to that ladder? Don't. There's no way to survive that fall. I don't see a way to get across. Unless there's a cave down there. Possibly that over there. See what I mean? Like that. I really wish I had my binoculars. This is basically just cleanup before going back to the... Is there not an item in here? Okay. Oh wait, that guy fell. That was probably the item. Yeah, why not? Okay. door, wouldn't it? Oh my god, I still can't believe that worked. I see you, ice crab. Freezing mist. Sorcerer Sullivan, before leaving the painted world, created a cloud of near freezing mist. Sullivan was born and raised in South Korea, yet no use for his original mist. He had not yet experienced loss. Wait, so somehow Sullivan came from the paint. You know, considering everything, if you remove all the ice, I bet this is just the painted world of Ariamis. Okay, there's the ladder. I almost missed it. How did I not notice it? Gotta give it the FromSoft. The games might be buggy. It looks beautiful as hell. Okay, so that wasn't the ladder I was thinking of. Interesting. How the hell did these ladders stay up? Pretty worth it. Yeah, I'll just head to the bonfire here. Bonfire here, walk down there. Kindle? Yeah, I should kindle myself. So they put it in two more Titanite slabs for this thing. interesting. Oh yeah, I watched Team Four Stars stream last night, so I know the boss coming up. I also know that apparently if I the last ending, if this save had used the lawn door dark ending, then I would have not really additional dialogue, but like it looked. Well, I don't know. They didn't really get that far. I'll save the ember and for the rest of this. Oh shit. Tell me this doesn't scream Bloodborne, these frickin' flower fields. What the fuck was that? That was awesome! Is that a shield sword art? Fuck me. Allerheart. Weapon once wielded by the champion of the undead match? Special paired set consisting of a broadsword and a lion shield. The champion fought on without rest until he lost his mind in the end. His page and lone wolf stayed at his side. Lion stance. One of the stance used normal attacks to thrust forward with the shield up, and strong attacks to execute a shield bash with the lion's roar. So it's a dueled weapon that has a shield. That's a pretty quick moveset. This is a gladiator fucking weapon, to be sure. Standard. Okay, so the heart attack is actually a shield bash. Interesting. Interesting. What was the champion's bonus? It's gotta be a key, right? Burn at firing to unlock the undead matches. Okay, interesting. Okay, so this. So that's a. That's freaking Artorias' fucking gravestone, isn't it? How it ended up in a painting, I will never know. Oh, fun fire. You don't deserve this! You kinda don't, there's one right over there. What's this one called? Champion's Grave Tinder. Alright, so before we attempt that triple boss, let's check out. I'm going to go to the place. I'm not gonna do any PvP. Are you kidding me? With this shit? Hell no. Alright, so I am on New Game Plus 3. Burn Champions. Dead Monk. Okay. Brawl co-op match on it. Oh. One-on-one fight that. Use of Estus is forbidden. Use of action is limited. Six, so away for that's pretty interesting, actually. The only arena is to kill him on the first flight. I bet that'll be, I bet they'll add more with the other DLC, or I just have to do it once to unlock. That's interesting. Using the bonfire as a competitive PvP. Interesting. That's very interesting. Hey, and if anyone's worried, why aren't you spending your souls? I can't afford you. Oh wait, I just beat a boss. Graveyard should be back. Damn it. Since his third and last stop is the castle where he's destined to die, I guess I shouldn't really care. It's only his first stop. I didn't do sit here and try to spawn a 7. Summon this guy, because there's no way in fuck I'm gonna beat this on my own. Thank you. apparently this is possibly the sister of Londor. Those that founded the stable church, whatever. Oh shit, there she was. Damn. God damn. Lucid's just so good. That's no fair. Fuck him. Damn that fucking attack is so strong. Oh my god! I'm doing so much worse than my first try!
Return from whence thou camest, for that is thy place of belonging.
Oh my god. Oh my gosh, she hits so hard. And her scythe goes through my shield. I might have to switch shields. Damn, her attack is so delayed. Thank you. Oh, she does a quick dash. That's what she does. What would happen if I let that guy live through this? Fuck it, I'll find out about this channel. Her soul, might as well look at it. Probably makes your dual sights. One of the twisted souls. Soul of Sister Freya, one of the twisted. Freya was the first Ash to enter the pain, but together with the good father, they chose rot over fire. Now that's a very interesting soul. It's dark yet frail. Okay, I showed you fire. He was hoping I didn't have to win with that guy alive. Pretty much I have no idea what else to do other than to go talk to the painter.
Those who aren't kin to fire cannot paint a world. Those absorbed by fire must not paint a world. Don't worry. I haven't forgotten, Mother.
Those who aren't akin to fire cannot paint. Those who are absorbed by fire must not paint.
I can hear the fire crackle, and soon I will see it. My thanks, Ashen One. I will finish the painting of a cold, dark, and very gentle place so that it might make a home for someone someday. My thanks, I will, so that...
I'm so confused. My brain. Did I just beat the DLC? Not even in an hour yet. Over the fire. What the hell does that mean? Chose the abyss? Despite a few people, I don't really see that much of the abyss here. It's all frozen over. God, I'm so confused. Okay, well, let's see what her soul makes, at least. Oh yeah, I got a weapon from the other guy, that's why. Nope, not what I wanted. Okay. Or makes her scythes? Or whip. Rose of Arendelle. Oh, this is that guy's flail. Flail used by the bulbous father of the painted world to shred his own skin, produce blood to appease flame, both a weapon and a miracle catalyst. Arendelle, being the restorer of the painted world, knew that it was painted with blood and only blood could protect the city. What? Skill, awakening, finally fill oneself to trigger an awakening that temporarily boosts strength and miracles, just as the good father used to rose himself. Okay. Great snake wielded by Sister Elfried. With a curved blade thinly coated by the painted world's frost that can easily break the guard of shields. In the painting, the scythe is a symbol of a long-lost home, possibly explaining Elfried's preference for it. Skill. Elfried's stance. Conjure a magic blade's support scythe into the left hand while the great scythe remains in the right. The scythe stands driven from Alfred's former swordsmanship. Use normal attacks to leap forward and swing twice. Strong attack coat the earth with running frost. What the hell? Okay, I'm going to make the scythes. See how this bullshit panders out. Does all magic. Interesting. crossplay. Okay, and now weapon art. The whole interesting. The activation doesn't cost anything, but the heavy attack does. Huh. You know, it's times like this I really wish you could just give weapons to new characters. Because I would definitely try to make Dex character with this. And I guess that's the end? Huh. Yeah, Grey Rat's back.
Oh, it go.
Obviously, he doesn't have much. He just finished his first.
Goodbye.
Made sure to collect everyone. Because I like this place having people. Well, I guess I might as well show off the PvP. Might as well show this. It's the last thing I can. I'm really surprised. Well, it was 4 hours long. Oh, come on, we still have to beat Red Phantoms, really. Interesting. This guy's played here a lot. God damn it. Holy shit! I got Gwyn's crown! Okay, either that was a testing puppet, or that was an actual person and I got lucky and I stunlocked him. Because he missed his parry. Okay then. I guess that's it, guys. I guess I'll see you the next time the DLC comes out. I'm Dark Grave Knight, signing off.